Welcome to the Boiler Studio. I'm Richard Firth. We're in VIVA Training. We're going to take you through how to service the Potter Tunner Show, which is the same as the main Eco Compact, the Baxi 800 and the Baxi 600. We're going to take you through it and see if we can give you some tips along the way. Health and safety first. So from a safety perspective, we always follow TB118. We're going to do safety touch. So we're going to get our Volt Stick. We're going to prove that it's working, and then we're going to just wand it across the case, make sure that there's no signs of electric there, and across the pipe work, and now we're safe to touch the boiler. So when we're servicing a gas boiler, always remember your 26.9 checks, the regulation 26.9, which covers the flue, the gas, and the safety of the boiler. So when it comes to the flue, you'd check the flue according to the manufacturer's instructions. With a modern flue, you've got the outlet and the in at the same place, so you check that outside. Potentially not too low to the ground, that it's not blocked, that it's clear, that there's a grill over it if it needs one, and along its length, that it's the clips are spaced adequately, there's enough of them, and that the joints are not leaking in any way, shape or form. So for clarity, the air intake is part of the modern boiler, the room sealed boiler, the air intake is there, so your flue is including the air, which is you're going to check when you're checking the flue. So next up is the gas. We check the gas, the inlet, we can't check it at the burner because it's a zero governor. So we check the working pressure at the inlet to make sure there's sufficient gas to get the temperatures that we require and that there's the sufficient gas as per the manufacturer's instructions. And then we do a gas rate at the meter to make sure it's burning the correct amount of gas during its operation. So then to complete the process of checks, we check the safety operation of any safety devices. So we're going to force the boiler into lockout and make sure that it locks out within the required time frame as per the manufacturer's instructions. So now we're going to check the safety device. We're going to turn the gas off, as so, and then it'll go through a number of attempts to reignite, and then it will go to lockout. So it's made three attempts to reignite, and now it's gone into the lockout mode. You can see here, the error code is 133, which shows you that it's locked out. So that shows you that the safety device is working as it should. So now we can get stuck into the actual service. So let's get the front off the boiler. So now we've got the front off the boiler. We've got our testo analyzer all set up onto pressure. We've taken a piece out the back and put a little piece in there so that it now will measure pressure. So now we put a rubber hose onto our probe and we're going to proceed to check the gas pressure. So we're going to turn the gas off. We're going to unscrew the screw in the test point a little bit. We're going to put the neoprene hose over that. Then we're going to turn the gas back on. We're going to put the boiler onto full fire. We're going to do that by turning the hot water on, and I'm going to see what reading we've got. There we go. Get the hose over the test point, gas back on, and then we're going to put the hot water on, which will put it into full fire. It's now firing up. So checking the inlet pressure according to the manufacturer's instructions. Here the manufacturer's instructions for this boiler say between 18 and 22 millibar. We're recording 18.5, 18.6, so we've got plenty of gas at the boiler. If it was undergassed and we are reading below 18, we go back to the meter and check it because it could be undersized pipe work, the regulator could be faulty, or we might have a blockage. Once you've removed the hose, always test disturbed joints with LDF, so we give it a little squirt. So we're going to drop the front so we get a better view of inside the boiler. We're going to do a visual check. We're going to look for water leaks. We're going to look for any staining, any products of combustion, seals that may have deteriorated over time, the electrical cables, connections, just a good visual check to make sure it all looks like it's supposed to look. So with this being a modern condensing boiler, you always check the condensate trap to make sure that there's no buildup or debris in there. With this being a stainless steel heat exchanger, it's very rare that there would be any buildup or debris in there, but if there is, it's just a pop it out job and clean it. With the aluminium heat exchangers, there's more often the case to clean out the condensate trap. So we take off the condensate trap, we clean it, clean out any debris, and then we prime it with water to make sure that when we replace it and the boiler first comes on, that the products of combustion can't discharge through the condensate trap. So we always prime the condensate trap before we refit it to the boiler. So next we do the flue gas analysis. So before we do that, we've got to put the case back on the boiler and then we'll carry out our flue gas analysis. So we've reconfigured the flue gas analyzer into gas analysis mode. We've purged it in air, so we've got 20.8% oxygen. Now we're gonna put the boiler onto high fire and we're gonna displace any heat by running the hot tap. So twice quarter turn, puts it into high fire. There she goes. Put the hot tap on. And then we're gonna check the integrity of the air in the flue. So we're looking for over 20.6% oxygen to make sure that there's no cross-contamination between the flue and the air duct. And we're reading happily at 21.3%, which shows the integrity of the flue is absolutely fine. So now we'll move the probe across into the flue duct. So we've carried out our flue gas analysis and we're looking for a reading of less than 0.004 and a CO2 reading of 9 in the manufacturing instructions, plus 0.3, minus 0.2. And we're comfortably within that range. So we're already in chimney sweep mode, so we're gonna put it into low fire by moving the central heating controller down to the minimum. Shows it's 00, so we're in low fire. And now, as according to the manufacturing instructions, we're looking for, it's still below 0.004 for the flue gas and a CO2 reading of 8.5 plus 0.1 or minus 0.4. And again, we're comfortably within that reading. So that takes you through the service of the Potterton and the Shaw. All the readings were within tolerance, so the majority of boilers that you go to service would be in tolerance. However, if it was out of tolerance, then we might have to take the burn route and start cleaning. There might be seals that need replacing, but that's all for another video.